So now that we have understood what affects the resistance, now we'll talk about how resistance affects everything else. Okay, so we'll talk about circuit analysis now. Circuit analysis. Now you have this Ohm's law, very nice Ohm's law, which is linear relation between voltage and current, which says that V is equal to I times R. What is V?
Potential difference
across the resistance. Okay, V is potential difference across the resistance. It's not just any potential difference. Okay, so V is equal to I times R. What is I?
Current
through the resistance. Current through the resistance. So if there is a resistance connected, the potential difference across the resistance will be current times resistance. Fine? And along the direction of resistance, potential will decrease or increase? It will decrease. So the situation is like this. If current is flowing like this, okay, resistance is R, potential difference is what? I into R. Which will be at higher potential? This one or this one? So V1 minus V2 is I into R, or V2 minus V1 is I into R? V1 minus V2. So resistance will not increase the voltage along the direction. It will decrease. Okay? So these are a few basics which you should know. So this is how resistance will affect the things around itself. It's a resistance against the flow of current. Okay, so this current is supposed driven by a voltage. Fine, so current should go like this. Fine, so how resistance will oppose? It will have slightly positive polarity this side and negative that side. And that will happen only when this is at higher potential than that. Okay, if this becomes negative and this becomes positive, it is supporting the current. The current will increase. Getting it? It becomes negative resistance actually. Okay, it actually supports the current. So we have Ohm's law, which connects voltage across resistance and the resistance. But the bad part about Ohm's law is that it deals with only one resistance at a time. You cannot analyze multiple resistances together using Ohm's law, right? So that leaves us with an option that, you know, can I, you know, somehow convert entire gamut of resistance and treat it as if there is single resistance connected there. Are you getting my point? Can I say that these 5-6 resistances that are there, is there a single resistance which is equivalent to these 5-6 resistances? Then I will be able to use Ohm's law very easily and find out the current flowing through the battery and all that. Okay? So right now we'll talk about equivalent resistance. Write down equivalent resistance. Fine? So basically, resistances, so there can be multiple resistances at a time connected in a circuit. Fine. Now how they can be connected?
Series or parallel.
Is that the only way to connect?
Or the commutator.
Achha, tell me how these resistances are connected. How these resistances, are they series or parallel?
Both.
What do you mean by both? No. I mean, that is nothing actually. Combination of series or parallel doesn't mean anything. Combination of series parallel may mean that some are connected in series and some are connected in parallel. Okay? That's a meaningless word when you say combination of series or parallel for the same resistance. So how these two resistances are connected, suppose this and this, how they are connected? No, are they series or parallel? No, they are neither series nor parallel. Similarly, this and that, neither series nor parallel. Fine. Series and parallel connections are special cases. There can be infinitely many ways resistance can be connected. Okay? Series and parallel are just two special cases. So when it comes to a nice looking formula, you know, all that, we are dealing with only two special cases. Okay? These two special cases are series and parallel. So let us first try to analyze how to find equivalent resistance when resistances are connected in series. I think we have discussed similar thing in case of capacitor also. There also I told that series and parallel, they are the two special cases. Okay? So suppose three resistances are connected like this. R1, R2 and R3. They are supposed connected across the battery like this. Battery source is V. Okay? Fine. What? We are trying to say that if is it possible for me to replace all these three resistances with a single resistance of value R equivalent without this battery knowing about it. As in nothing should get affected across these two points. Can I replace these three resistances with a single resistance? Okay, and if I can, what is the value of that in terms of R1, R2 and R3? Okay, try to derive it yourself. If this is current I, what should be current here?
I
only. Okay, what should be current through R1?
I.
R2?
I.
R3 also I. So, in series connection for resistance, current should have same value. Write down. If resistances are connected in series, all resistances will have same current. Okay? When you derive, okay, you have to find out a relation between what is happening here and what is happening there.
Yeah.
You need to connect these two circuits. Then only you will be able to find out a relation between this and that. Fine? So try to connect what is happening here with this. Okay, so suppose if this is point number 1 and this is point number 2. This is also will be 1 and that is 2. Isn't it? Isn't it? So potential for 1 is same as potential here. It's a conducting wire. Potential for 2 is same as here. So potential across R equivalent is what? V only.
Yeah.
Potential difference across R equivalent is V. Okay? And what is the potential difference across R1? Let us say V1, across R2, V2, and across R3, let us say it is V3. Okay? So can I say that the total potential difference from here to here is sum of all these potential differences?
Yes.
Yeah. Right? So I got a relation between what is happening here and there. V is equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3. You have connected these two circuits with an equation. Now you have to do what? You have to bring resistance in the equation because you are finding resistance. Until this resistance comes in the equation, how will you find it? Right? So what is V if you look at here?
I by R
equivalent. V is equal to I R equivalent.
Yeah.
Right? V1 is what? V1 is potential difference across R1. You can use Ohm's law there. So this is IR1. That is IR2. And this one is IR3. So R equivalent is R1 plus R2 plus R3. Getting it? So we have found the same thing which we have already found in class 10. The resistance, equivalent resistance in series connection is sum of the all resistances. So equivalent resistance is more than the largest resistance of all when they are connected in series. Any doubt on this? Fine. So that is series connection. Let us find out for parallel connection. Write down parallel connection. How the resistance will be connected in parallel?
Parallel. Constant. It has the voltage.
This is how they are connected parallel. They should be connected across the same two points. Like this. This is voltage V. This is R1, R2 and R3. And I am saying that this is equivalent to a single resistance of R equivalent. Like this. If current here is I, what will be the current here?
I
only, right? Now, what is the relation between what is happening here and there?
Potential difference
here will be equal to potential difference here. So V is equal to V you will get. But that is not the relation you are looking for. That will not fetch you anything. Sum of the current in each of these three will be equal to current here. Isn't it?
Yeah.
Right? That is more meaningful relation. I is equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3. Suppose this is I1, this is I2, and that is I3. So that is the relation, right? I'll write I using Ohm's law from here. So what will be I?
V by
R equivalent. So this is V by R equivalent. It will be V by R1 plus V by R2 plus V by R3. So I can say that 1 by R equivalent is 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. And if there are more resistors connected in parallel, you can just keep on adding. Any doubt on this? Okay. For two resistors, suppose you have only R1 and R2. For R1 and R2 only, you can do some sort of analysis. As in, 1 by R equivalent is 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2. So R equivalent, you can write it as R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2. So R equivalent can be written as R1 multiplied by R2 by R1 plus R2. This can be also written as R2 multiplied by R1 by R1 plus R2. Isn't it? Right? Now tell me one thing. Is R2 divided by R1 plus R2 is less than 1
yeah.
and greater than 0?
Yeah.
So multiplying a number less than 1 and greater than 0 with R1. So R equivalent will be less than R1?
Yeah.
Right? And it is also less than R2 because this bracket thing is again less than 1.
Yeah.
Fine? So R equivalent is less than the least resistance. Fine? Suppose you have 1 million ohms connected and you have to decrease its resistance. Just connect 1 ohm across 1 million ohm. Equivalent resistance will become less than 1 ohm itself. Okay? So, equivalent resistance in parallel connection is less than the least. Okay? Any doubts till now? Nothing? Okay.
Is the potential difference
the
same?
No, potential difference will be same. If they are in parallel, potential difference will be always same.
No, if you take it as symmetrical.
Symmetry works everywhere actually. If all two resistors are same, current will be equally distributed. If two resistors are same, in this scenario, those two resistors will have same current, as in same value current. Okay, let's take a numerical. Draw this circuit. This is V, this is R1, R2 and R3. Okay? First find out equivalent resistance total between this point and that point. Then you find out this current and after that you find out these two currents. Basically you need to find R equivalent, I1 and I2. Okay, done? See, these two are in parallel and then equivalent of these two in series with R1. So R equivalent should be equal to R1 plus R2 R3 divided by R2 plus R3. So you will get R1 R2 plus R1 R3 plus R2 R3 divided by R2 plus R3 as R equivalent. All of you got this?
Yes,
sir. Smart. So how to find current I? V by R equivalent. Fine. Now what to do? How to find I1 and I2?
Sir, because the current flow on the system is equal to the current
flow. We find the potential on R1.
So then the current flow will be same. So that whole equivalent, because V is equal to IR. So we can find out the force or the potential across that whole thing.
Correct. So the equivalent resistance is what? This is also equivalent to. This is equal to R2 R3 divided by R2 plus R3. I can write like this also or not?
Yeah.
Right? So I have found out this current. So what is the potential difference between these two points? This current, which is this, multiplied by that.
Yeah.
Right? So potential difference between point number 1 and point number 2, V12, is current into R2 R3 divided by R2 plus R3. Once you get potential difference, same potential difference is across R2 and across R3 also. So now you can use Ohm's law. So I2 will be what? V12 divided by R2, and I1 will be what? V12 divided by R3. Fine? Any problem? Okay. Sir, similar question you might have already done in class 10.